Good morning, everyone. Minister, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Virginija Būdienė. I am the director of Vilnius Institute for Policy Analysis. And on behalf of our institute, we are honored and very happy to welcome all you here in Vilnius Consultations 2019. Vilnius Consultations is the annual event of our institute. It's already third time we are organizing those consultations, and it's always dedicated to the hot issues of the contemporary world. We dedicate this conference, Vilnius Consultations, for the 15th anniversary of Lithuania's NATO membership. First of all, I would like to thank all our partners and sponsors of the event. They made our consultations possible. And our sponsors are the Ministry of National Defence of the Republic of Lithuania, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs of the Republic of Lithuania, embassies of the United States, British Embassy, Embassy of the Kingdom of the Netherlands, and a Spanish Embassy. Also, Open Society Fund of Lithuania, also the Program of Foreign Ministry, Lithuanian Development Cooperation, and Foreign Policy Research Institute from the United States. For the introductory speech, I am honored to invite the Minister of National Defense of the Republic of Lithuania, Raimundas Karoblis. Minister, the floor is yours.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, dear colleagues, friends. Welcome to Vilnius and to Vilnius Consultations. It's a great pleasure to open today your discussions. First of all, congratulations to organizers, Vilnius Policy Analysis Institute, for putting together such impressive program and, of course, collecting so impressive list of speakers. And also for making new approach, so in respect of the teams related with hybrid. Indeed, it's a fresh approach, and it's really very important for that to concentrate on hybrid threats and their various manifestation. This is really a very complex topic. The range of issues which you will address today is a perfect illustration to the complexity of the challenge before us. And of course, we keep discovering new risks and threats as malign actors keep developing new methods and new areas. And of course, really we need to adjust also to these new threats. And we see that the battlefield in this gray zone keeps changing, and this is also in changing environment. We also need to adjust to that. Unfortunately, there are no ready formulas on how to deal with wide variety of non-conventional threats. Each country will have to develop its national responses. However, the smart thing to do is this dynamic environment is to keep sharing information, keep exchanging best practices, share intelligence, and engage our societies. Consultations like this one make important contribution to the building of resilience in our countries. They increase our awareness and our understanding of these threats. We in Lithuania like to think of ourselves as experts of Russia's hybrid tactics. Indeed, there is little secret that we carefully observe and study Russian actions in Ukraine, including on hybrid. Ukraine is the only country so far which has experienced the full force of Russia's hybrid warfare, including the use of conventional military capabilities. This combination of hybrid and conventional methods is something we in the Baltic states are particularly concerned about. We therefore train our military to work with police and civilian institutions. We exercise different scenarios as at the national, EU and NATO levels. But there are many of the less lethal manifestations of Russia's hybrid activities which challenge us on a daily basis. For example, NATO forces in Lithuania, first of all, the enhanced forward presence battalion led by Germany, regularly attacked with fake news stories aimed as discrediting the mission. Yesterday we had the celebration of German Unity Day, but also a week before approximately it was serious attack against German soldiers. So majority, which are Lithuanians, saw this fake news that German tanks destroyed Jewish cemetery. And then German troops painted the Nazis' symbols in the cemetery. And for us, we saw that, and the conclusions are very clear that it's Photoshop, that absolutely fake news. But main attack was not for Lithuanian society, but for wider. And this message has appeared in the mass media of Israel, mass media in the United States as the real one. And of course, it was necessary to put quite a lot of efforts to explain this situation and to remove this issue as the real story also internationally. Well, this is also one of the examples of the complexity and also geographic effect which is by created by the fake news. Myself, also I was target of information on cyber attacks in several locations. As you see, I survived. However, it was not a pleasant experience, and I must admit, and of course, we live in this situation, even this environment, and of course, without any doubts, so each or other of us could be, could have such attacks also in the future. All these attacks are very hard to attribute, but the evidence that we have collected gives us solid reasons to believe that they originate from our neighbors in the East. As the saying goes, what doesn't kill you makes you stronger. We have learned a lot over the recent years. Today we are much better at identifying hybrid influences and at reducing our vulnerabilities. I will mention just a couple of areas where the Ministry of Defense has special focus and responsibilities. First of all, we monitor our informational environment in 24/7 regime using traditional methods as well as artificial intelligence. Our Stratcom services cooperate closely with all the main national media outlets. This allows us to spot, to stop the spread, and to debunk fake news stories before they cause any serious damage. It works for Lithuania, but as mentioned, not necessarily in wider sense. We have centralized Lithuania's cyber security and cyber defense responsibilities under the Ministry of Defense. This centralization has allowed us to enhance cyber security standards across the country, which was a particular focus on the critical infrastructure. These efforts have already received international recognition. All recent international cyber security rankings place Lithuania among top 4 countries in the world. Furthermore, in the EU framework, Lithuania is leading cyber rapid response project, which should keep the EU countries deal with major cyber attacks. Last but not least, we work very actively to spread awareness of hybrid threats with the Lithuanian society. The nature of the threat requires the engagement of the whole population. People should know what to do and who to call in case they noticed unusual activities. The basis for the cyber hygiene or how to assist the armed forces in crisis situations. All these measures are aimed at higher vigilance across the society and reducing the effectiveness of malign activities. In other words, we seek to create a difficult operational environment for our adversary. Lately, and also probably we'll discuss that, we are also becoming increasingly aware of China's activities in the region and potential risks which this may entail. Of course, the threats of China and which are going from China and Russia is really different. With the first, with Russia, of course, we have already feel the conventional military plus hybrid threat, while with China is different approaches, strategically more competition with the new methods, also methods related with gray zones, but indeed it's the long term risk and the issue. The topic of Chinese influence is gaining prominence also within NATO and EU debates. Therefore, I welcome the attention which your consultations will devote to China. I very much look forward of reading the report from your today's consultations. And with that said, let me once again welcome you to Vilnius, to this conference, and really I wish very successful contributions which will make definitely significant impact to our common work tackling the hybrid threats. Have a nice discussion.
Thank you, Minister, for your kind words. Indeed, today, gray zone strategies are prevalent as ever. The ideas to demilitarize Eastern Europe 17+1, the use of unregulated political influence strategies, disinformation, and shady investments, all these political processes are pushing Europe and Lithuania beyond its limits, and thus forces us to rethink political strategies that would allow us to reduce the risk of new gray zones. That's why this year's Vilnius consultations revolve around the topic of gray zones, not in completely traditional way, but beyond it. The conference is divided into three conceptual panels. We call those consultations. The first consultation will focus on gray zones and role of shadow actors. The second consultation will discuss how vulnerability of our personal data and architecture of social networks turns us into very vulnerable citizens and what to do with it. After the second session, we'll invite you to the small lunch. After the lunch, we will have the third consultation and we will talk about China's infrastructural investments and its implications for Europe and for Lithuania. We will close today's consultations with a keynote address by Martin Swarovski, comparing Russia's and China's strategies in Europe. And now I would like to introduce our keynote speaker, Jose Grinda Gonzalez. He is Spain's national court prosecutor who over a decade has investigated Russian transnational crime networks in Spain and Russian export of corruption. According to the renowned author Mark Galeotti, Spain is at the forefront of European efforts to get rid of dirty money, especially thanks to the works of Jose Grinda and his colleagues. According to our guest, Spain is uniquely situated to act freer against Russian transnational organized crime because it is not important geographically and do not have economic interests in Russia. This is, I quote him. I believe our guest will tell you more about the fighting transnational organized crime and pushing back against Kremlin's kleptocracy in Europe. Jose Grinda will speak in Spanish, so please use your headphones for translation into English. So I'm inviting Jose Grinda Gonzalez to speak here from this tribune.